We have KZ in the building. KZ has been compared to Lauryn Hill. Can we just get like
Lauryn Hill? Come on, come on.
Has been compared to Lauryn Hill with her amazing rap and singing skills. Woo. So has sold out stages from Dubai to the Philippines and soon New York. Woo. Has an amazing stage presence and captivates the hearts of millions. And will be recording additional international music. Can we give up for KZ?
But I'm so nervous.
don't be nervous. Listen, we're all family. Listen, before we do anything else, because let's stop teasing the people.
Come
do you
on.
Know what I mean? Let's stop hanging, dangling that carrot there. You're going to give us a little performance.
Yes, I'm going to sing an original from my latest album, Soul Supremacy. But it's going to be in Filipino because I really want to sing in Filipino.
I am so excited. We are home to so many different cultures in London.
I'll explain maybe later if you have questions about what it's about.
So I know it's called Alone Again.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
You did your research.
Yeah, we go through. We go through. So listen, why don't you head over to the mic and get yourself comfortable and we can have a little chat about it.
Yo, nag-iisa, nag-iisa na naman. Oh, bakit ba walang kadala-dala? Oh, tama na, umiiyak na naman. Oh, ang hapdi, oh, ang hapdi ng bighati. Ngayong nag-iisa na naman. Gulong-gulo at ang sakit sa ulo. Pinipilit kong limutin tong matatamis mong pangako. Wala do oras, ngunit meron palang iba. Ibibigay do ang lahat, ngunit may sobra pa sa kanya. Ano ba yan? Di na tama, ngunit di mapigil-pigilan. Di ko matigil-tigilan ng damdamin kong baliw na baliw. Niloko mong harap-harapan. Pagising ko'y wala ka na nga. Nag-iisa, nag-iisa na naman. Oh, bakit ba walang kadala-dala? Oh, tama na, umiiyak na naman. Oh, ang hapdi, oh, ang hapdi ng bighati. Ngayon, nag-iisa na naman. Bulong-bulongan ng lahat kung paano mo ko pinaikot sa iyong mga palad. Ilang taon ba ang sinayang? Laking paghihinayang. Bakit sa'yo pinikit ang mata? Alam na lahat sa pag-ibig ako'y bulag-bulagan. Tinamaan ng damdamin. Pagdating sa'yo, lahat ay kayang ibigay. Maging itong buong buhay. Hindi isa, hindi dalawa. Kahit ilang beses mo pa akong ginagawang tanga. Oh, ganun na nga. Ngunit tama rin naman sila. Dapat siguro, di na pinatagal ng ganito. Oh, Diyos ko, ano ba to? Di na nadala ulit-ulit na lang. Ano ba ginawa? Ngayon, hindi mo na minamahalo. Nag-iisa, nag-iisa na naman. Oh, bakit ba walang kadala-dala? Oh, tama na, umiiyak na naman. Oh, ang happy, oh, ang happy ng bighati. Ngayon, nag-iisa na naman. Nag-iisa na naman. Oh, bakit ba walang kadala-dala? Oh, tama na, umiiyak na naman. Oh, ang hapdi, oh, ang hapdi ng bighati. Ngayon, nag-iisa na naman. Kulang pa ba ang pagmamahal? Kulang pa ba ang nilaan? Bakit nag-iisa na naman? Oh, kulang pa ba napadama? Kulang pa ba tumanap ka pa? Bakit nag-iisa na naman? Oh, kulang ba? Kulang pa ba pagmamahal? Kulang pa ba ang nilaan? Bakit nag-iisa na naman? Oh, kulang pa ba? Kulang pa ba napadama? Kulang pa ba humanap ka pa? Bakit nag-iisa? Beside myself.
Yo, hey, oh my god, give me the clicks.
Come on.
Yo, we need something just to make a huge. Yo, we need to make some noise
Come
in
on,
the building.
Hey. Listen, that was absolutely incredible. Casey, thank you so much for sharing that with us. It was such a privilege to actually sit here next to you and watch you perform that, to see your expressions, to see the way you were in that song. Oh my God, tell us. Give us a little snapshot of what it was about.
The song is called Alone Again. So in Filipino, it's Nag-Iisa na naman. It talks about being in the face of your relationship where in the beginning, you already know it was going to end. It was going to end badly. Mm-hmm. You saw the signs, but then you chose to ignore the signs. Mm-hmm. So now you're suffering the consequences of, you know.
So you know what?
This is why I like that song so much. Do you know what I mean? Now I can see why I like that song so much. Because you know when you see the red flags and then you pick up the flag and you go in the parade with the flag right there. You know what I mean?
And you still go with it.
You still go. Girl, talk about my love life like that.
That was fire.
How are you? Thank you so much for coming into the studio. If you were not here, what would you be doing on a Friday night?
I usually just stay at home and watch Netflix or something.
Oh, you lot be lying to us, you know. Netflix. Now you lot got some superstar lives.
Wait, what are you watching on Netflix right now?
I'm rewatching Big Bang Theory.
I haven't seen that.
It's so funny because it's like a sitcom of four genius men who have so high IQs, but then they don't have like
basic common sense, right?
Go on, Sam. I know you want to say something. Go on.
I hate Big Bang Theory. I hate it. There's just so much awkwardness on one stage. It makes me die inside. I'm like, just stop being so
So that's
weird.
Your kind of stuff, right? That's what you like watching.
Yeah, it's so funny, yeah.
Anyway,
right. We want to know about you. I just gave you an amazing intro. Hopefully it was amazing, right?
I'm just guessing myself.
Okay, cool.
So much pressure after your intro.
How would you introduce yourself to people who haven't met you before? Other than saying like you could be compared to Lauryn Hill, like how would you introduce
Which you really should
That
lead
really
with.
Adds so much pressure on me right now. I'm KZ Tandingan. I'm from the Philippines. I sing.
Rap?
I sing and I try to. I don't really say that I'm a rapper. Maybe I just talk fast. That's why they think I'm rapping. So.
Do you definitely identify then more as a singer?
Yeah, I'm more of a singer. I learned to rap when I was already in the university.
Oh, okay.
So when did singing happen? How did that come about? What's your journey to singing?
I started singing when I was 3. That's what my dad tells me. But I used to be a power builder in the Philippines. When you're a singer, you should be able to hit the high notes. And then when I got to the third year in high school, that's like junior high.
It's like secondary school or like primary school.
We're trying to like translate from Filipino to like American to then the British system. I'm like, what
is it? It's different in the Philippines. Yeah, so I grew a polyp on my vocal cords and that kind of stopped me from singing and hitting the high notes. So I almost stopped singing altogether.
Because of that?
Yeah, because of that. But it kind of pushed me to find who I really am as an artist. And that kind of made me realize that, you know, singing isn't just a one color, it's a colorful rainbow. That's not music isn't just one genre and it isn't about just hitting the high notes. You know, it's telling the story and making
souls.
People feel. Yeah.
How did you feel to kind of develop a polyp on your throat and kind of that changes the way that you can sing and obviously it changes. How did that feel for you?
At the beginning, it kind of felt like I was cursed because, you know, singing is my life. Every day I sing, I shower, I sing. You know, at an early age, I felt so depressed that my dream was going to be taken away from me because of the polyp. But, you know, I believe that when you see things from a different perspective, it kind of pushes you. You know, it changes the direction of your life and it realigns you to your goal. It inspired me. Now I'm thankful that it happened because if it didn't happen,
you might not have been here. Like, yo, you could be a public speaker secretly, you know. We might have to organize this
for
a couple
for
stages.
Motivation.
Like, seriously. No, because so many people go through like hardships in life. Yeah. And I feel like sometimes that is the reason that they never push themselves beyond it, right? And
Absolutely. To
be in a very, very competitive scene, to be a singer, you're like, oh, you've got like hundreds of thousands of people, if not millions, competing to be where you are right now. And you are there because you didn't stop yourself. That is incredible.
That is very.
I always say to never give up on your dreams and that every failure is just a redirection to where you should be.
Listen. Hey, these are quotables right now, you know. Ooh, okay.
Do you know what? You can tell we're poets. We're always snapping out here like this.
But I can only snap with one hand.
One hand. Oh my God, my friend's like that. She can't slit with her left finger. What is that? Mad.
Just with my left.
Don't worry. You're bringing the bars. We're snapping for you. So you don't need to do anything. Don't worry about it.
So a birdie tells me, right, that you was on the X Factor in Philippines.
Yeah, I won the first and only season of X Factor in the Philippines.
Do you know, I wasn't even going to say you the winner. I just wanted to kind of like sizzle it in, but you're like, no, I'm the winner of the only one.
No, no. Listen,
let them know.
Let them know. Let
Take
them know.
Sorry, let sorry, them know.
Sorry. You won the X Factor in the Philippines. That what an amazing.
Own it. No, for real. Yeah. Own it. That is you. You're the number one, and no one else can be that.
What an amazing achievement. How was that?
It's an amazing journey. It will always be an unforgettable journey for me because I grew a lot. No, not physically, because I stopped growing when I was in elementary.
Just
in
emotionally, metaphorically. Yeah, got
but
it.
But I grew spiritually, and you know, I grew as an artist when I joined X Factor because I had to be away from my family for a couple of months.
Right.
How old were you when you were in X Factor?
I think I was 20.
Oh, wow.
But in the Philippines, when you're 20, you're still young. I know out here
when you're 30, you're still young. I know what you're talking. Listen.
No, I was going to say, you're still young here. That is really young. Like 20 is young. You know, there's so much you haven't experienced yet, right? Okay, she's like, no, actually, I was fully grown.
Yeah,
I was
grown.
I've been around. I've experienced. I know what's up. Okay, cool. Girl, school me. I'm here for it. Let's go.
So like, where do you see your career going then in like the next 3 or 5 years? Because some people, when they reach your level, they think, oh, I don't know what's next. And maybe there's a lot of pressure to become something, to become the Beyonce of the Philippines or whatever it is.
Yeah,
like,
when you win the X Factor, where'd you go?
I mean, to be fair, Lauryn Hill of the Philippines, right?
Lauryn Hill of the Philippines.
Oh my gosh, right? Oh my gosh.
Do you have any pressure in terms of like what's going to allow you to get to that next level?
I actually just want to, you know, want to try to make music internationally and, you know, make OPM, original Filipino music, known internationally. So I'm just really thankful that ABS-CBN, the network that I'm working for, is actually putting a lot of effort in, you know, supporting talents. So yeah, maybe I think next month we will be recording a lot of songs in LA, and hopefully we'll be releasing them by the end of the year. So
that's amazing. And I think actually now's such a good time for it because we're seeing such a resurgence in music, of music from other cultural backgrounds, and the Latino music that's coming through. And I think that's
Afrobeat is killing it right now.
So there's such a space for that, and I'm so excited to
hear. My Facebook is KZ Tandingan. My Instagram is also KZ Tandingan. My Twitter is a little different. It's KZ Official, but it's still
mixing up, innit? You're just having fun with each of them.
Some people took my username.
Some people took my... Listen, I've had the same problem on Twitter. Someone took my username.
That's how you know you're famous, man.
For real. Listen, we're gonna thank you so much for coming on. Like, seriously, like, any last words from both of you for tomorrow?
Yeah, what have you guys got planned for the rest of your time in London?
See you all tomorrow. We're so excited to perform for all of you. Please don't forget, London Barrio Fiesta will be on day one. I'm going to be on day one with Inigo Pascual. Mm-hmm. And on day two, there will be a bunch of artists. So please do come.
There's going to be lots of food, lots of games, and there's rides as well.
So. You got me
with your voices. Like, listen, I'm there.
And this collaboration needs to happen. I'm saying it, and I'm speaking
We're claiming it.
Do a little collaboration, and then we'll do another one. Lion and I will feature on it, do a bit of poetry. We'll bring together the magic. Do you know what I'm saying? Do you know what I mean?
Let's make it happen.
You're not going to teach me the language though, man. I want to do some poetry.
Oh, wow. Guys, what have you got planned for the rest of your time in London? Is there anything that you're looking forward to doing here in London?
Gonna eat more Nando's.
Eat more Nando's.
Chicken, for sure.
You are legit.
Would you recommend anything else?
Oh my God. Yes. What do you want? Food, drink, activities?
Anything. Food.
Food. There's loads of incredible restaurants in London. You could go up the Shard. There's an amazing restaurant up in the Shard.
We're about to have dinner, like, tonight. What would you recommend somewhere nearby?
Go to Red Rooster. In
Red Rooster.
Like, in Shoreditch is good. Mac and cheese is dope.
I love mac and cheese.
Check it out. Fire. There's something called Chicken Shop in Holborn. They do an amazing chicken as well. But also, if you can make it, get up to the Shard or get up to one of the tall buildings in London. See the sunset. Have a meal. There's loads of late night places up there for drinks. Take in the city. Soak it in. And soak in just how brilliant you are.
Thanks, guys. Thank you so much. It is such a
pleasure having you. Thank you for coming in. Thank you for sharing your talents with the world and sharing it with London, especially. Yeah, it has been such a pleasure having you on, guys.
We are looking forward to seeing what you guys do with your career. Like, honestly,
it means a lot.
And this is gone.
I was going to say before we didn't ask KZ the question about single and if you get more done. This ain't over.
Okay,
this ain't
when
over.
You ready?
So I think you saw me I agreed. Yeah. So now I'm in a relationship and he is also a singer-songwriter. So it kind of works on our advantage
because
he understands the
work, the lifestyle, everything.
But you know, if something goes wrong, you're going to be writing about each other, right? You know that.
I know.
Like, imagine both battling for the number one slot.
That's some Taylor Swift. And God forbid, hopefully nothing does go wrong. Absolutely not. But I mean, that song, Alone Again, is brilliant. And do you see what I mean? I'm saying heartbreak. It brings out great art.
But wait,
it's actually easier for me to write songs if it's about heartbreak.
I'm exactly the same. When I'm happy, I got nothing to say.
Oh, no. You're not just trying to do this to me. No, listen.
Come on.
No, we're going to make sure that we're all staying in love. Listen. We're going to make it happen for you.
In love with myself.
Oh my goodness. Listen, you've been listening to This Scene with myself, Lionheart, and the beautiful, intellectual, sophisticated Salmael
and Lionheart. I don't even pay him to say that.
I mean, you could though.
You have also just heard the incredible vocal stylings of KZ, yep, over from the Philippines, and Inigo Pascal, who have come and shared their talent. We also had Yasmeen Rahman on the show earlier.
Yep.
If you missed any of the guests, and I promise you don't want to miss them, you want to listen back, head over to the BBC Sounds app, download the app, get involved, listen to the show again, make sure you head over to our socials where you can interact with all of the guests that were on our show tonight, holler at them, say hello, let them know you love their work. Lion,
I love you, man. Thank
I love you,
for
you man
listening.
It's been a pleasure. Ooh, come on, I love you, man. Soul Radio
94. Thank you so much.
What a show.
Thank you so much for having us.
Yeah, thank you.
I know, right?
Unbelievable.
It was amazing.
Unbelievable.
And I got the news, though. And I got the news,
Yo.
Yo.
Nag-Iisa. Nag-Iisa.